Dude. We'll take the money. God, he's terrifying. I think I got this fight. He's dead now for 4 turns, Sujak. Okay, here we go. Oh, very little goblin archers this time. Interesting, they put their dudes on the walls here. Okay, we'll put the goblins here. The main army is here, so that's where I'll put these orc arrow boys. All I see here are goblins, so these goblins should be more than enough to handle anything here. And keep the boys on the wall. Oh, these guys can run around outside. I'll just do it with one of them. Alright, so... No, you can't put peeps in towers, but yes, you can aim towers. But like, you can capture towers, and that's considered like, you know, putting people in there. They shoot once they're captured. But you're not literally putting infantry inside. Yeah, Gumindong, he can do this every 4 turns. But so can my legendary lord, and my legendary lord is an equal badass. I don't know if it's worth putting these spiders out. I'm gonna do it anyways. Just to break off whatever this is. Please destroy those. Purpose of this is to lead these infantry guys into my entire arrow line. Perfect. Nice. Wow, they didn't even get the towers on the wall. Move them over here. Or you know what? Let's move them here. Oh, they're sitting up.
Gonna kill him! Alright!
who is up here. Oh yeah, this is gonna be so easy. These towers are way too strong in my opinion. Like, you can't... I don't mind it now that I've learned how the mechanic works, but they're super strong. I don't like how strong they are. But if it never changed, I guess I wouldn't cry about it. But it still works in my favor. Sorry, boys are getting on. Alright, so clearly these guys aren't gonna do anything. Move these arrow boys over here where they can contribute. Oh, why is this open now? Oh, because units are retreating through it. There's a mod that weakens them? Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, I mean, on the one side, it makes it so you have to attack sooner when you are sieging yourself. But, on the other hand, it makes siege defense, like, super easy. But on the other, but even though the siege tower doesn't make it, you don't lose the squad for losing the tower. So ultimately, the only thing it really does is kill artillery and just force them to use ladders, which is the same exact thing. So, I mean, that's the reason why I don't mind it too much. It just protects infantry from approaching from archers. And that's the only real reason to build it. Also, it provides like a mini wall for your artillery, so... In that sense, I don't really care that the towers get owned by the siege tower gets owned by the archer tower. And that's my reasoning behind my opinion for the way it works right now. This guy is just owning. No, your men can't push the ladders off the walls. There are boys, a little closer to that side. This is where we leave. What? How did you get through? Why? Why is the gate opening for them? What the fuck? I hate how you can't control the gate. Oh, I guess it blew up somehow? Yeah, this is the same game, no restarts yet. fuck is that shit? Alright, I guess it just wraps the game up. They must have, like, retreated through the gate. You really should be able to force close it. I honestly wouldn't care if there were a bunch of units clumped up on the gate because they routed the wrong way. I mean, I'd rather have that than the gate opening. We'll take their money. We don't need fightiness on a fort unless it affects fightiness around the board. What stance is he on? March stance?
Past the time. I'm off.
Now, I could invest in here, but I don't think it's worth it still. We'll crush this army. Wow, this is gonna be a joke. I'm not even gonna fight it. Eat them. Good money. Now, where exactly is he headed? Probably to Death Gorge.
Begun.
Oh man, that's not good. What you want? Let's try to block him. Perfect.
You think so?
Perfect, perfect. Good job. I could finish this army off. Alright, what does he need? He needs to be cheap. So let's do this. Let's get the goblins so I could get that 18 count. This guy's gonna chill here. Oh no, this is bad. Oh, I'll go negative if I lose this. Shit. If I'm lucky, this boss's shack will prevent it from expanding even more. Why are they so angry? The corruption. Yeah, I'm aware of the assassination mod. I'm thinking of it. I don't exactly know if I want to do that though. If I clean up this army, it's gonna be harder to save Death Gorge. But I think it's what I might need to do. I'm gonna get the boss's tent here. I don't feel threatened by any stacks that exist in this corner of the world. So, let's get a boss's tent. If I lose the settlement, it's just more of a reason for me to work on a wall with this army. I should be able to sweep up that army. Swa's working its way up. If only I had 5 units for him, but won't be happening for a while. It's deteriorating, why? My military actions with the dwarves are dropping, is that why? Sounds like it.
The chopper is in my hand, so...
Okay. Well, while I can, let's see if I can extort him for some money.
What are you good swans?
Good. And this I can reinvest into my own settlements. Getting a heap of shiny stuff here, but it's still a pretty shaky settlement that I don't want to really work on. So, this is worth investing in. Get the boss's tent here. Katamin's gonna be super hard to attack. What I can do is this. He's slowed down, so we can finish off this army. I'll take the leadership buff. And we'll put him in march stance. Head over to Death Gorge. I should be able to teleport there next turn. I want a mod that disables land auto battles, so I can't be tempted to abuse it. I mean, sometimes you just gotta save yourself time. Fortunately, Eric only gets salty when he's losing. Yup, I get salty as fuck when I lose. It's just unfortunate for me, but I'll try to fix it. It's his first Total War game, and it's my first time watching a Total War game, but, like, watching any battle Enrique does makes what In Control is doing seem crude. Is that so? Wow. That's a great compliment, man. Thanks a lot. In Control's a really good gamer, though, himself. Most streamers playing this game are so terrible. Yeah, but most people streaming it are also very first-timers. It's nice that they're streaming it, because it brings a shit ton of publicity to this game. Yeah, Total War games are high skill ceiling, primarily because everyone playing them are, pretty new. And every Total War builds off the previous one, expecting you to have learned from previous titles. I think I'm done here with this turn. I can't really do much right now. Filthy casuals, what's up, Panish? Oh, this is my troll army. I better get the fuck away. Oh no. What happened to my Waaagh? Oh no. What happened to my Waaagh? Oh man, this is bad. I'm gonna lose. This is gonna hurt. I was supposed to win this fight easily. I didn't. Man, dwarves get some serious auto battle buffs. Terrifying auto battle buffs. Are these forests? I have no idea how to formation this. Yeah, I know. Why did they skip Total Warhammer? Why did they say Total War Warhammer? It's tiring to say it. I'm assuming this is a forest. We'll work with this. Trolls on the far flank. The general is gonna lead. Biggins will come last. The catapults are gonna be hitting me early, so I'll hit him while he's in the gorge. These trolls have to carry their weight. He's gonna challenge the hero. Apparently he sucks against heroes. That's not good. They're not supposed to break this soon. That's terrible. Oh my god. That is just stupid. Alrighty, what happened to you guys? No, actually, we don't need to do that. You know what? Get him hiding around these guys and try to flank, sneak a flank in here. These trolls need to get the fuck back in. Oh my god, look how badly they're dying. Can I just put them away? There we go. I should have done the first fight. They can just catch up to me. Now I lost this entire army because I retreated instead of doing two full fights to bleed them. This is going to be a hard army to kill. I shouldn't have led with my trolls. I didn't realize how fast they run. Oh, this is bad. This is a huge setback. Yeah, Orc has a pretty strong AI group, or range unit group too. Like, Arrow Boys are fucking amazing. I just took this fight, like, way too poorly. On top of that, he outnumbers me, so my morale is getting hit too hard. Like, obviously, he's 12 units to 11 or whatever, but... Well, I'm just one unit behind him, but he just out-techs me, so my guys are obviously gonna get destroyed. Like, if I had a full line of Orc Biggins to take care of these Dwarf Warriors, then the fight would go drastically different, but... I can't afford that, so I have to go for bigger, but I was hoping for my Waaagh to deal with that army. But I think my Waaagh died, too. I can't have Top Knots take care of my army, or take any provinces from me. Simply because I have to siphon him. Alright, this settlement's safe, especially if I can get this level 2. If I can, which I will definitely get this level 2. Was that successful? I didn't read it. World events, hero activity, failure. Still think so. So... here's what happens next. I recruit an army here. Under... this one. He's gonna get me two trolls. Trolls are pretty cheap for upkeep. So we'll get two trolls, two of these things. Now, if I fight this army, I'm gonna be in a shit ton of trouble. So instead, I will attack this settlement. Alright, perfect. I'm gonna take Crad Tommen with this army. And he should get his Waaagh back. Oh no, I have a rebellion here. Alright, so he's gonna have to take care of that. It's gonna be a rebellion here soon. Can't do much about it, I'll just let it happen. Keep an eye on this group too. So if he makes a move on Death Gorge, I run right back.
I am the High King.
The Chopper is in.
Speak up, or I'll take your tongue.
I'll take the non-aggression pack. Did that fail? Okay, let's get some money running. Settlement's pretty safe, I'd say. Karak Azul will definitely hold. Definitely. I mean, ideally, I would have Biggins protecting the walls. But even if I fail, I'll have... I should be able to dent the army there. Length of their facial hair. Man, dwarves don't fuck around, man. Look at this, rank 7? We can take him. If only I could direct this guy's armies.
Nah, them boys.
How much money do I have? 3124. Now, he doesn't own any settlements I want, so I want to start trying to boost our relationship with money, but not now. Oh, there's my Waaagh! Right? Or is this somewhere else? Who are you part of? Is this my Waaagh? Yeah, he's my Waaagh, okay. Yeah, let's just auto-resolve, this isn't really worth my time. Meet the captives. Oh, that's Karak Azul! Did he kill both? Oh, this guy is a beast! He's a fucking beast. Where the hell did he go? Where did he go? Oh, Doc Karaz, I'm gonna lose these two, and I'm totally fine with that. That was just a buffer zone. I'll capture it another time. I'm not even taxing it, so I really don't give a shit. Oh, he's after that army, isn't he? If not, he's going after Crad Tommen, which I will capture. so Black Crag is safe no matter what. So I don't really care about that. How is he leveling? Why are you level 2 already? 3 already? Is that a benefit of being orc? That's pretty cool. Oh, if the Waaagh disappears due to fightiness, they can come back later with the same EXP. That's pretty cool. Oh, okay. Alright.
Don't think so.
Well, I know where I'm sending this Waaagh. Brother. Even if you die, you must go and destroy this man. This need to capture Spite Pig. Oh, this guy's becoming quite the beast. Let's give him Root Marcher. And he will capture this. Where's this army headed? It's peacing out. Crookfang Fort might get attacked, though. So I have quite a bit of moving to do after this. We'll fight this. I want to see how a dwarf castle fight works. I'll be right back, though. I want to take a piss first. Eric, do you ever use the forces button? I'm aware it exists. I tend not to click it because I'm a lazy bastard. Okay. Set your banners before you fight? I will. But before I do this fight... What is this? We don't want battering rams. We want siege towers. 3 of them. Depending on what this looks like, I will probably not want to rush into this. Let's not put it on you. You're the one that needs it. Magic resistance will keep on him. Hold this siege. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna invest all of my money on blocking this army. It's not happening!
No.
He's gonna go for Crookfang Fort, if anything. I'm hoping to block his army and teleport him here, because I'm not threatened by this. This Waaagh is going to take care of this, and then hit Black Iron Mine, and then stop this if it takes that long. And this guy is going to go ahead and capture Misty Mountain. Now, I'm wondering if doing that will slam this fightiness. When your heroes are doing actions against- if it doesn't ask you for a declaration of war, then you are. It is hurting your relationship with that faction. In previous ones, if a ninja, for example, stayed hidden and wasn't captured, which was very unlikely, it wouldn't hurt relations if he got away. But I mean, that's really as the extent of it. Alright, this is the last turn they're gonna exist for, so we might as well extort them for income. And everything else is looking pretty sick. I'm hoping Top Knots is willing to go kill some bitches. If not, help me capture Crad Tommen, that'd be amazing. Worst case scenario, maybe I'll have him travel to Crad Tommen first. Yeah, you know what? I think I'll have him help me capture Crad Tommen. I have a feeling this Waaagh is just gonna get fucking wrecked. This army looks like it doesn't fuck around.
Alright, you got my attention. Watch it.
This is my tribe, so talk!
I must say, the orcs are super fun to play. They're so different from playing Empire. Alright, good. He's leaving me the fuck alone. It looks like he's going back, if anything. Maybe to deal with the chaos. Or to fuck up another settlement that's farther away from me. Oh, this is an easy fight. So I'll resolve it. Right? Yeah, I have archers and cav, whereas he has just the wolf riders. I don't think this is worth fighting. It's not worth my time. I'll just auto resolve it. Extra teeth? How is that? One of your most trusted bosses has come back from a raid empty-handed, and so he says, but he's. And so he says, but he's wearing a right nifty helmet and. One of your most trusted bosses has come back from a raid empty-handed, so he says, but he's wearing a right nifty helmet. It's all shiny. Where you get all that dosh to polish that helmet? Holy cow, that's hard. Fightiness for all forces -3 or leadership. We can't really. I'd rather have leadership. Alarin, thanks for the follow, man. I appreciate it, dude. Alright, so we got raiding. Oh, he's not helping me? Really? Why isn't he helping me? Why isn't he helping me? He should be helping me. I thought I would get help for that. That doesn't make sense.
Alright, you got my attention.
How do I get a military alliance out of you? As Empire, how did you move out? Like, you take some people you start at war with, then who do you attack next? It seems you're surrounded by people who are allied with others or get pissed off if you attack anyone. That is true. What you want to do is just capture Reichsland, and if you can, capture Middenland for the economy boost. If you can't capture Middenland, that's fine. Just stay in Reichsland and see if you can, you know, crawl into any other settlements. I found it particularly easy in my campaign to move east, but most people would try to capture Middenland for the economy boost. After that, if you can capture the one settlement north of your capital city, capture that, and then just hold it, wait for the Chaos Invasion to come. Once the Chaos Invasion hits, you'll get huge diplomatic bonuses with your allies, and then you just make confederations with whoever's left once the Chaos are beaten. that's pretty much the strategy for Empire that I found would be a standard. Alright, let's get this dude moving up here. This I can spend money on, but that would cost everything. So
begin.
The Lea Sorrow is too hard to attack. I don't think they would do it. Iron Rock, on the other hand, is very easy, so that's where I'm investing my money. This army can start getting some cheaper boys or air boys. We'll get two of these. You know what? I'm gonna go for... Yeah, we'll get two of these. And probably Goblin Archers, but I'll wait till I have more money next turn. It's very easy to hold the capital of Reichsland against any army, and so that's like... It's why I suggest just capturing Reichsland and not worrying too much about getting too far in the campaign. This is gonna be scary.
Don't think so.
And he's just chilling there waiting for an attack to happen.
What do you want?
Oh, he needs money. Let's see if he's willing to give me some cash.
Nah, damn boys. Speak up.
Nope, not anymore. What about the bloody spears? They fucking hate me.
What a warning, boys.
Rock mill.
Speak up, or I'll take your tongue.
Who are the dwarves at war with? Vampire counts. How is my relationship with the vampire counts? Terrible. Alright, so I'm not gonna make money off anyone. That's too bad. Damn, if only these guys would help me. It doesn't make sense that they won't. Oh, it's because they're in underground stance. Okay. I understand. What do you guys think? You want me to fight this? Would you guys like me to fight this? I'll wait like 30 seconds for a response to see what the general consensus is. I feel like I would win this easily, but it might be interesting for you guys. I love spreading my aids as vamps, nice. And seeing all the armies slowly wither away. Yeah, I feel like that would be... that's why I wanted to play vamps. It sounded really cool to do that. I would definitely take some casualties, both on the Waaagh and the... I'll take Waaagh as a yes. I'm gonna take some pretty heavy casualties regardless. Ideally, I'll try to rush in quickly as possible, especially with these Wolf Riders. Okay, alright, we'll take the fight. The spider people will have to, Three wins, two autos, one loss. Okay. It's gonna be hard, I mean, I don't doubt it. But I'm pretty certain I'll win. Oh, it's very cool how the AI is responding to my deployment. I have to move quickly with my ally so that we can keep the leadership bonuses. Goblins will take the flank. These two in reserve. Spiders on the left. Archers. I have to make it so this group gets beaten up instead of anyone else. But I don't think that's gonna happen. I wish you could tell the AI what to do. Better yet, control them. One thing I would have really liked, and I guess it's also up to... This could totally be an opinion thing, but it'd be really nice if you had a military alliance that you could opt to take control of a battle. So if they're in a faraway land, then you can take that fight. And then make it so that you have less battles overall to handle. So that way, each fight that you have personally would mean more. Alright, good. My spider people are fucking up their formations. That's what I want. No, my spider people! Yeah, good. They have a terrible formation. Oh, these two will be flankers, actually. Oh my god. I can't even see what's going on here. Oh, it's so hard to get these formations rolling. Those are quite the mosh pit. Let's prevent these guys from hurting people for a bit. Do the same to them. God, their morale is so ridiculous. It is so fucking ridiculous. Spiders are really good for repeat charging, by the way. Starting to learn this now. Look how quickly they can pull out from a fight. Not a single one of them are tied up. And then they shoot on their way back, so it's like pretty fucking awesome. I love these battles where there's no fucking battle line. It's just a pure mosh pit at a rock concert. Just meleeing with my fucking air voice. I mean, in the current state of the game, I wouldn't want to fight all of my AI allies' battles. Not even any of them. It would be too many battles for me to handle. I would get tired of doing them. But, like, if there were lesser battles, and then you could control your military alliance's fights, that'd be pretty cool. Damn, the losses are just fucking staggering. Let's get them in a melee with Skiro. Alright, we can just speed this up now. It would be something risky to try out. Like, I don't even know if I would like it, but it'd be something, I don't know. You get to try more of the races per campaign, and you also get to have more significant battles. Hey Thorstein, thanks for the follow, man. Appreciate it, dude. Is this bitch dead yet? Look at him go. Yeah, someone like that, D. Jensen. Oh, did he die? I hope he didn't die. That would be brutal. Let's not let him go. I need my diplomacy to be improved with. Maybe.